I'm all for that too. And now we battle again. Pylai die. Come high ground and die. This is not going to be good. And the Gale ignites on Bone 7. The Spirit will come in, but the first blood has already been spilt out by Alliance. So the Shu is pretty good, damn good job. Like, I know, it's 6-2 up against a 5-0.
Oh no, S4, this is really troublesome for you.
But then again, with RK coming in, there might be an upset or something seems to reach the tower. S4's fine.
So, he might feel a little bit pressured as soon as the bottle comes out, and lo and behold, there it is.
RK, a little bit late to respond on this one. The cogs will come up, but Bone 7 hasn't really caught its way out of this one. And EGM still has
poisoning.
He's body blocking him up so they know they can get themselves another blast. And with RK able to throw out the nuke, Lodi coming in with the Dapper Crack, Dapper Bulldog. Eternal Envy with Searing Arrows. Pylai Dai coming through the rim. Eternal Envy, he's taking up the tower, he's taking up the Whirling Death. Pylai Dai is going to come in. Body block's not going to help him out here. And Vogue just picked up the Shadow Shaman with a little bit of.
Didn't know about this.
Dapper Bulldog's here as well. He doesn't have a Shark and Revival.
Oh my gosh, this is gonna become so clowny right here. Holy moly.
Lotus here as well, they're committing. It's full commitment. Bone 7 got hexed up. The Plague Wards are up on the higher ground plus the Forge Spirits. S4's going back in to finish this. He's trying to finish it off. EGM is making a bit of a filter here. Searing Arrows, Eternal Envy, Roshan, the Aegis Immortal is picked up by Shadow Shaman. Bone 7's in, he's in range of the Mass Serpent Wards. They're still alive after killing off Roshan. So Alliance take Roshan.
There's no need for like more than two Arcane Boots max for
team. They just spotted Owie. Hex to start with, and they do. He commits the wards. It's just a ward trap. He's already wanting to walk away so they can focus over on Pylai Dai. And he's going to get himself in range. I don't know if that's in range for a shackle. It's got to be on the edge. With Sing Sing coming in, Eternal Envy, Cold Snap as well being triggered on S4. He'll lose the Aegis Immortal. Pylai is still in the neighborhood, but Admiral Bulldog, Sharkham is a filter. The Mass Serpent Wards are still in the neighborhood, but they're not running up for that one. Clockwork is not looking healthy. He's up on the top lane, where Venomancer was able to get, actually it's Luna who gets. There goes the Mass Serpent Wards. He knows behind it. Yeah, they're TPing out. Pylai Dai, though, he doesn't have a TP. He's gonna die
dear.
Down here. He can throw out the ulti as one last ditch effort, but an easy split for Alliance. Only the Chen army is affected by it. So they'll take the tower here while up on top lane. You get caught up inside the Mass Serpent Wards, and Chen is still going to keep him alive long enough. He's just keeping tabs for the Clockwork Rocket. And there's no TP's back. So you're right. Trade for trade, nothing. But if they lose Loda like they're about to on this bottom lane,
it
is not worth it. Hookshot's going to miss though. Loda didn't run away. The Sunstrike's coming in. Loda walked back into it. Which means the last Searing Arrow from Eternal Envy will get the kill. But they've got to commit. There's players TPing down. S4 as well as Admiral Bulldog. The question is right now, can Speed Gaming still make this worthwhile? The cogs are there, that's going to buy cover space for Bone 7 to TP out. They'll see him, but it was too late for the Lucid Beam to hit. One person who is moving down and get a Gale out, and Sing Sing connected. In fact, he tried to move back and walk back into the Gale.
The
Chen is still there for EGM. He's going to realize the horrible mistake. The Meg Charge will trigger. He never even used his Force up. He's trying to turn around and try and kill off EGM instead. We'll end up dying on this bottom lane.
Yeah. Oh, you know what the worst thing about that was? Is that, yeah, the Ghostwalk, because he has low levels in the West, he's super slow. He basically just added on to the Gale saying, okay, I'm just going to slow myself for you even harder, because he didn't know the gem was there. And of course, as you said, with the Force Staff, it was actually on cooldown for 3 seconds. He would have lived the duration of the cooldown if he just walked straight with Wex without casting that Ghostwalk. So that's why it's so unfortunate, because if he actually survived, Alliance might have actually backed, but now he needs to be extra aggressive.
Trouble, the Shackle is worth committing this time around. Got him. It was a beautiful four star up. And Envy's trying to get a trade in the tier 2 tower. That will not be fast enough or in time. Alliance high ground. They've got Mass Serpent Wards level 2 off cooldown. Why not?
Oh, they're doing it. You're right. They have the Serpent Wards, as you said. They're doing it. And I don't think this can be stopped right now with Speed Gaming's heroes, as well as their amount of farm.
Yep. Look at the Forge Spirits as well. Like, they're tanking up a lot of the Mass Serpent Wards. So Sing Sing just lost his small negative armor army. And Venomance is putting a tent up right inside the base of Speed Gaming. They're just going to focus on the rags. Now we've got to remember the bouncing glaives effect as it goes through the building. Sing Sing and Envy are taking harassment damage.
Beautiful
hook in with the Eclipse. Maybe there's enough damage. The ET only will summon back, but Hand of God as well as the mech. Alliance's ability is through the roof, especially when Lorda triggers his BKB in the middle of the fight. They've taken the melee racks. They've taken the clockwork. Elden Titan had to run up north, because if he ran down straight back to base, he would have in fact just died. Like, physical damage is all we require.
Yeah.
Like, they don't care about the magical burst damage on Envy, because they know the bouncing glaze from Loda. We are not
going again.
A lot of support here, and massive wards revolve from S4. They get a Gale up, Pylai die. He's in a lot of trouble. Whirling Death, another Timber Chain. Use it. There she goes. Loda might die a little bit further up, but Eternal Envy is tanking up the Mass Serpent Wards. Shadow Shaman is going to be the trade off for him. but they're moving back up to Mass 7 Waters. Speed Gaming can't force this any further. While Clockwork, I'm not quite sure how he was in that deep or why he was in that deep. But either way, it becomes a 3-for-2 trade, but maybe not going to end there. Admiral Bulldog on the chase. Sing Sing will go Invis. The question is, does Bulldog, he turn around Bulldog. The chain? He turns around the chain, sees Sing Sing, but now he sees him too late. Gale!
Oh!
It would be a little bit further down attack from that direction. And if they want to, they could have attacked direct on as well. But they don't go in because they realize they can't. S4 now throws in the Mass Serpent once again, and you add such a huge buffer. Clockwork, he's going to try and hookshot in through the rear, and when he does so, at least got RK in position. If he can kill up RK straight away, before we see the mech, before we see the Hand of God, then maybe they got a chance. ET Ollie, there's your hookshot in. Hand of God to go. Mech as well. RK and the S4, they're actually killing themselves. They killed themselves on the Blade Mail. Eternal Envy was able to dish out a decent amount of damage in the fight too. EGM kills over. Then you got Loader and Admiral Bullock, the only ones left up. The Mass Serpent Wards will bring down this tier 3 tower.
They're not out of this one yet, man. They can still come back from this.
It's going to be a rough time to come back from this. Like, we're not KPs up and running. And you already got one from Eternal Envy, but you got it so early on that late
game. Oh, suppose this theory though.
In, but they got the 4 star away. Envy, S4, he just jumps in and throws the Mass Serpent Wards so they're in range. And now with the shotgun, he's trying to bring down Bone 7. He's going to do so. He's fighting inside the base. Sing Sing already had to buy it back. The Shackle's holding Envy in position. Loader, he needs more, but he can't see him anymore. But the Mass Serpent Wards are down. The Bouncing Glaives are doing their work too. But the balls from S4 to just jump in right there and having the cheese save his life. The blinks in, the blinks down. They're searching for a kill on Aoi and they got it. They call the GG. Alliance in 28 minutes in game number 2 of the D2CL Grand Final. Be taking themselves one game away from taking the lion's share of the prize money.
Wow. And you know, that what seemed to be like a slight glimmer of hope in that hook coming out of Bone 7, unfortunately there was not enough follow-up in terms of the cogs or the additional stunts, potential stunts coming out of the side of Speed Gaming. So I feel like not...